Police Centenary, Australia and New Zealand. Mark and Zach Day. Australia and New Zealand are remembering soldiers from the two countries who fought at Gallipoli in Turkey during World War I. Events throughout Saturday marked the centenary of the Allied landing on the Gallipoli Peninsula. A dawn service was held at the landing. Australia later remembered its dead at a service at the Lone Pine site. PM Tony Abbott paid tribute to their selflessness, describing them as Australia's founding heroes. More than 11,400 of Australian and New Zealand Army Corps ANZAC troops were killed in the course of the campaign. ANZAC Day is arguably the most important national occasion for Australia and New Zealand. Gallipoli hold a special place in Australian hearts. Many believe it was here Australians proved themselves the equal of any in the world, heralding the young nation's emergence onto the world stage. Read more about events during the course of the day here. Meanwhile in London, the Queen, the Duke of Edinburgh, who is patron of the Gallipoli Association, and Prince William were joined by senior government and military figures to lay wreaths at the cenotaph in Whitehall. In Scotland, First Minister Nicola Sturgeon and Scottish Secretary Alistair Carmichael were due to join veterans and members of the public in marking the anniversary at Edinburgh Castle. About 131,000, of whom 45,000 were Allied forces and 86,000 from Turkey, died in the campaign. The fatalities included about 25,000 British military personnel and 10,000 from France. Founding heroes, thousands from Australia and New Zealand are in Turkey for the anniversary, along with Princes Charles and Harry and a large number of international dignitaries. Australians commemorated their dead with a service at Lone Pine, the site of a bloody battle on the Gallipoli Peninsula in August 1915. The service began with Australian school children reading out the names of some of the fallen. In a speech, Prime Minister Abbott stressed the importance of the troops in Australia's history. "To us they are ANZACs, but in their day they were fathers, sons, parents, children, cousins and mates just as you are now," he said. "You walk among their headstones, you read the inscriptions, you hear the epitaphs and you hear their families speak. In these inscriptions and in these epitaphs we hear the echoes of our country a century ago. We wonder at their selflessness, at their capacity to face death," he added. At a dawn service to mark the landing, Mr. Abbott described the Australian troops as the founding heroes of their country. At the same event, New Zealand Prime Minister John Key said that Gallipoli had become a byword for the best characteristics of Australians and New Zealanders, especially when they worked side by side in the face of adversity. A quotation by Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, the founder of the Republic of Turkey after the fall of the Ottoman Empire, was also read at the service. "You, the mothers who sent their sons from faraway countries, wipe away your tears. Your sons are now lying in our bosom and are in peace. After having lost their lives on this land, they have become our sons as well."